All right, the GPU bench is back in action. Today, I'm going to be checking out a couple of GPUs that don't have any display outs whatsoever. These are part of the CMP series of mining GPUs, very similar to the CMP 50HX we looked at last week. However, these are not Turing-based cards, T-U-R-I-N-G. These are Ampere. So you would think of this more as an RTX 3000 series card instead of an RTX 2000 series card. This is a GA102-100. So this is basically a 3080 10 gig. And yeah, you can see there are holes for video outs on the back plate, but there aren't any video outs. I will say they've actually anchored this much better. It's actually got a aluminum casting on the fin stack there. Looks like we have three 95-ish millimeter fans. This card does not look like it has any use on it at all. Pretty snazzy. It does have a full-size PCB, so it's not quite the same as the reference. Thermal pads look good. It has thermal pads on the front and back side of the PCB where the memory is, which makes sense because this card was sold exclusively for mining by NVIDIA's CMP team. And I've got two of them on loan to me for the next hour. So let's hop in and do some benchmarking before I decide whether I buy some of these. The CMP 50HX that we tested last week, I was able to get for about $139 each delivered to my door after everything, or $129 a unit before those fees. These cards are about $240 before those fees, so they're a fair bit more money. All right, that should be pretty good. So let's look at stock performance. With a 119 watt power limit, which is really pretty darn low, they do show up as CMP 90HXs, Micron memory, obviously. Let's up this to a 245 watt power limit. Really get them chooching. And let's get Hive Shell going. Let's see what they can do balls out. Oh, Envy Tool. That's not good. These cards will not declock. All right, let's try. That would explain the really bad power consumption. Ooh. The memory will not throttle. I don't know if I like these cards. Interesting. Let's see if we can lock it with Mini Z. The cores seem like they're really good though. 2 gigahertz is a very strong clock for one of these bad boys. Wow, yeah, it just refuses to downclock the memory. That is problematic. For core algorithms, for memory stuff, it doesn't probably matter at all. 65 souls is pretty bad at 183 watts. That's a lot worse than a 3080 10 gig. So we're changing over to Caspa. I'm trying an 810 lock, but we just know that that's not gonna work. Yeah, still 9501, not good. But we'll see what it gets on the core algo. This is a pretty aggressive offset. We've got a 1510 core lock, 275 offset, and I tried locking the memory, but the memory lock will not take. So not great efficiency there. We'll call that 4.285, which is about the same efficiency as a P106. That's not good. So bummer about that. But as you can see, again, we are not getting the requested memory lock. We're staying at 9501. So these are GDDR6X cards, which means that memory is drawing a ton of power just sitting there doing nothing. So no good for Caspa. Okay, so I just pushed Ethereum Classic flight sheet to these cards, and I'm going to go ahead and leave the power limit in place, but I'm going to set the memory 3000, and we'll set the core to 1295. Oh, I think I crashed it. Yep, she crashed. So here it looks like we're doing, where's the efficiency? 450 and 463. That's good, but it's not great. Let's pull the core down some more. Let's try 950. 960 looks like it's bottom, but it did take. That should bring our power down, hopefully. 178. Oh, that really cut hash rate. Oh god. I guess let's try bringing the core up. That's about the same efficiency, so let's see if we can get more juice out of it. Oh, 90 mega hash. Okay, these are actually getting a little bit better. That's just so dumb you can't tweak the memory, though. So 90 mega hash for 200 watts is actually pretty good. The efficiency got better on this one. 464. That's the best we've seen. And there's Ergo. So 195 mega hash apiece at 145 watts. 1350 core. No mem tweak because it's not allowed. That's okay. It's not great. It's not terrible. I gotta say, I'm not sure if I can recommend these cards. I was really... These would be fantastic if you could lock the memory. But you can't. At least not on HiveOS with the latest NVIDIA drivers and running 525.85, I believe. Latest as of March of 2023. Tried NVTool, tried the miner. Nothing can lock the memory on these cards. It gets the request, but the driver won't push it through to the card. So I gotta say, 90HX, that's a no-buy for me. Even at $233, I think the 50HX is kind of where my money's at. That's actually a bummer. Well, time to throw the 3070s back in the test bench and call it a day. Well, that registers correctly. That's good news. Oh, nice. Okay. Well, let's open a miner with a default profile. The system is drawing 311.3 watts. Okay, that's 88 mega hash. That's about what we were getting in Hive. 1410. 1305, that's pretty good. Uh-oh. Did we crash it? We crashed it. 89.16, okay, let's try 150. Oh shit, did that actually take? Oh shit, boys! 89.69, it is working. Well, so it's not a vBIOS issue on the card. I want to hop back into Hive and do a Hive replace, which has an older NVIDIA driver and an older kernel package, and see if we can get that to chooch. Okay, that I think is a pretty decent OC. So 90 mega hash, 219 watts. It's not too far off what we were getting in Hive. I don't buy that. It's like ignoring. Oh, the memory dropped to 405 megahertz. Oh, here, P8. It was definitely showing like P0 before. Memory. Oh my god. Yep, so it supports 405 and 9501. But that means we could probably offset it from both of those. And honestly, 405 might be okay for Caspa. Yeah, it's ignoring it. Crap. Oh, that is dog shit. Oh my god. Oh, it's like 200 watts. Let's see what it gets up to in hash rate. But the CMP50 was doing higher hash rate than this at 50 or 60 watts lower. 650 for 210 watts. Oh, that's bad. Oof. Okay, so we came, we saw, we did not like. If we ever get an memory hard algorithm again, these actually will be tremendous cards. I mean, they're like Radeon 7 efficient for those. It bottoms out at negative 2000. That's what this was. Because it's half of that, and this is almost exactly 1,000 megahertz less than its effective clock. GA102, 6400 cores, 8700 cores. Oof. Okay, so I went in two steps, and that worked. However, then the miner forces into P8, but if we restart the miner, I think it'll bring the core back up. That has to be tricking it. Yeah, yep. Wow, okay. So you have to go negative 1004 in the GUI, then negative 2000, then restart the miner. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be buying any CMP90s. I think I'm going to go 50. That's all she wrote, really. It's tolerable at Nexa and Flux, because those use a little bit of memory. It's probably pretty good at Raven or KawPow. I guess we could try KawPow. Oh, never mind, it's worse. Good God, man. Okay, it's not good at KawPow either. Yeah, the CMP50 is a way better card. The fact that they didn't even bother to make an IO shield for this. Yeah. This is basically a slottable ASIC. It's like a really inefficient slottable ETH ASIC. Yeah, and like if they didn't require signed BIOSes, and maybe the CMP cards are less strict on that, but I doubt they are. You could, in theory, enable, you know, more memory frequencies, because the memory controller is clearly exactly the same as a 3080 10 gig. Yeah, I think they just gimped it because they're lazy. Like, there was no reason for them to do any other modes. Like, you have idle, and you have balls-to-the-wall memory. So, it was ETH or idle. That's what this car was designed for. So, I'm glad we tried it, but yeah. Very happy we didn't buy, like, 20 of these.